Hello, everyone. Pastor Greg Pufo here to bring you God's Word on this 100th day of school or Groundhog's Day, whatever it is that you are celebrating today. But before the devotion, just a quick announcement, a reminder about our Future Foundations presentations that are going on. We have a couple opportunities if you have not taken advantage of that yet. We have a couple opportunities this week. Tonight, Tuesday, 6:30, you can come and attend that event. Or tomorrow, Wednesday, there's also one at 6:30, but you can also tune in with Zoom if you would like to do that instead. Today, for our devotion, I want to talk about something that we are focusing on for catechism class with the students right now. That has to do with prayer. Now, of course, prayer is not a means of grace, catechism term for you. It is not the gospel, God's word being read or spoken to us, or it's not any sacrament. That's only baptism and the Lord's Supper. But that doesn't mean that prayer is not important or that we should forget about it. So I wonder, how do you feel about prayer? When do you pray? Is it something you do daily? Do you begin and end each day with prayer, or do you see prayer as a last resort? Maybe your team needs to make this last shot or kick this field goal to win. Now it's time to pray. I remember back before COVID, and I was able to meet with my people who are shut in their homes. And one of the ladies, I remember going to see her, and she stayed in the same room, the same 10 by 10, 12 by 12, whatever size room it was, same four walls, same furniture, same routine. And one time I came and visited her, and she had a question for me. She's like, Pastor, why am I still here? I don't really have a purpose in life. What would you say to someone like that? Well, you can always pray. If you tune into social media or, you know, if you have Facebook or watch the news, I'm sure there's always some times where there is some sad news that comes on. Maybe it's a parent who needs to take their infant child to a specialty hospital in order to have a surgery done that only this hospital can do. And so now there's this flight for life trip to this hospital. And maybe you see something like that and it just cuts to your heart, the different problems that people face. And you just say, I wish there was something more we could do than just pray. You ever feel that way? Ever feel like maybe you have no purpose in life or the only response would be, well, just pray? You ever found yourself in a dire situation which makes you feel so helpless that you wish you could do more than just pray? I don't know the exact words that I would have used to answer that kind of question, wish we could do more than pray, but it would maybe be something like this. Is there anything more we can do that would be more powerful than prayer? I get it. Prayer seems to be a last resort. It's often forgotten. It is power often gets overlooked. But, and it's because we are the get-her-done type people. We want to put in our effort to accomplish something. But prayer takes all our efforts away. We get taken out of the picture. There's nothing more we can do, so I suppose I'll give it to God. It can make us almost feel hopeless. You mean to tell me all I can do about this whole situation is talk to God about it? How do I know he's listening? How do I know it is doing any good? My answer, what more do you want to do? What more can you do? What does God say? Their Bible passage, James chapter 5, verse 16. The prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. What makes a person righteous? It's only when we have been covered from head to toe in Jesus and his righteousness. So if we're praying and we are covered in Jesus, how is prayer powerful and effective? Well, think about who's the one doing the praying for us. We're covered in Jesus. Isn't it the Almighty God and Savior Jesus, the one who covers us in his righteousness and his power doing the prayer for us? In prayer, we fall before our God knowing we have zero power in ourselves to do anything. And we solely trust in God to do what is best for us. Is there anything more we can do that would be more powerful than prayer? I would argue there is actually nothing more we can do, and even nothing more we would want to do. So prayer, I pray, is not a last resort for you. Prayer isn't just some kind of hope that we have, that we throw up to the sky, hoping that something's actually going to happen, but we feel as though it has no power at all. It isn't something we use the same way that we are hoping to win the lottery. Prayer changes things. Prayer puts all your concerns right into the lap of the Almighty God. Prayer takes us out of the equation and puts only God into that equation. Prayer is powerful and effective. After all, remember, when you pray, to whom you are praying. And perhaps that thought might change your perspective on the power of prayer. Let's say a prayer. Dearest Lord Jesus, we come before your throne today and we place all of our cares, our concerns, our wants, our needs into your lap. We trust that you will take care of us and watch out for us. Perhaps if we know someone who is going through a very difficult time right now, we also place them into your almighty, all-powerful arms. Help and heal, take away problems, and help us in any situation of life. Dearest Jesus, what a wonderful gift you have given to us to be able to come to you throughout the entire day, every day, to pray to you, to lift up our cares, our concerns, our praise, our thanks to your throne. Continue to help us use that wonderful gift of prayer and to have our hearts always trust in you. Thank you, dearest Jesus. Amen. May God bless every single one of you.